This video is about iterated functions like the iterated logarithm or log star function. If you just want to see that definition, jump to like the fourth minute of the video, but out of context, that definition might seem totally freaking random. You can understand what it is, but maybe not why we care. If you're willing to take a few minutes to get there, you'll see that the log star function actually matches the pattern of other functions that we already know, if we deconstruct and reconstruct them first. That'll make the next minute or two seem weird, but here we go. So look, kids learn how to count before they learn any function. So at some point, they can count to like 10. If you give them 4 blocks, they can count and get 4. But if you then show them that you're adding 1 block to that pile, they don't jump to 5. Instead, they count up to 5 from scratch. They know the names of the numbers, but they don't really understand the increment function. Now, we have the advantage of knowing the names of numbers for our discussion, but if we want to make things more formal, we actually start with just 0 and define the successor function such that 2 different elements never have the same successor. That pretty much defines something like, or congruent to, the non-negative integers, and that's how we will use them. For iterated functions on 0, like s of 0, we use integers as shorthand, and we also use integers as shorthand within the iterated function notation. We define function iteration in general, where you kind of nest the result from one iteration into the next. This is not taking the result of the function to a power, even though the notation is similar. So once we have that successor function and function iteration, we can use them to define other functions. For example, if you iterate the successor or increment function n times, you've added n. Addition comes from the iteration of the increment function. So now if you make a new function as shorthand for addition, and then we iterate over that function, we get multiplication. And if we iterate over multiplication, we get exponentiation. Now we already knew these, but if we keep going, maybe now we're going to get to something new. If we iterate over exponentiation, we get something called tetration, or the Tower of Power. All right. So anyway, you can keep following this same pattern to get more and more functions. You might notice that I plugged in a different base case 0 for going from addition to multiplication versus 1 for going from multiplication to exponentiation. This really comes from 0 being the additive identity versus 1 being the multiplicative identity. So let's look at some particular values for these functions when we use a base of 2 and consider n values of up to 5. By the time we get to exponentiation, we think of a function as growing quickly, but the tower of 2's grows much faster. A tower of 5 2's is thought to be way bigger than the number of atoms in the observable universe, so that's a really fast growing function. Next, we're going to look at some inverses, which can lead to some very slow growing functions. Using notation that's sort of consistent with before, we can define the decrement function. With a few more properties here, we could define negative integers, but that's not the main focus here, so I'll use them without definition. Next, I'm going to consider iterating over functions starting with the decrement function. To keep things simple, I'll just stick to the base case of 2, where to build one function from another, we use 2 in the simpler function, and I ask a strange-sounding question. How many times can I subtract 2 from n until it gets to 0 or less? Well, that really defines the divide by 2 function. And how many times can I divide by 2 before reaching 1 or less? That defines log base 2. And how many times can we take the log base 2 before getting to 1 or less? That's log star of n, or the iterated log function. It follows the same pattern as the simpler functions of addition, multiplication, and logarithms, or I should say subtraction, division, and logarithms, but most of us haven't used it enough that we think of it as its own function. Instead, we define it using the log function instead. Now, in the same way that we didn't need to use 2 as our base case for the fast-growing functions, we don't need to use it for these inverse functions either. We can generalize. But because log star of n is a function which does come up in computer science, I'll just concentrate on that here. So log star n is the number of times that we can iterate the log function until we get down to 1. Without context, that definition looks pretty arbitrary. But now we know that it just follows the same pattern as the other functions, subtraction, division, logarithm. in terms of that we know those functions well, right? So let's look at some values. If n is up to 1, log star of n is 0. By the time n gets to 17, log star n has jumped to 4. And it doesn't get to 5 until n is over 65,000. For all practical purposes, it never gets higher than 5. Anyway, if you want to see functions beyond the power tower, you can read about them online. But right now, my butt needs some iterated scratching.